Hello, I'm attorney Tammy Saltzman, and you are watching Divorce Connection Network. Today, I am so pleased to bring back into our studio Lori Dubow. Hi, Lori.
Hey, Tammy. So good to see you. Thank you for having me. It's another beautiful day in paradise.
Yes, it is another beautiful day in paradise. And Lori's company is called Signature Paradise, so she knows all about paradise. And today, we're going to be talking about real estate, and we're going to be talking about the importance of properly evaluating your marital residence in a divorce and all of the emotional issues that go along with it. And no one better to tell us all about that than Lori. Lori's been doing real estate for a long time, right, Lori? 15 years.
Yes.
Her dad was a real estate attorney, so she's grown up around real estate issues her whole life. That's what they talked about, and that's what was part of her life. And before that, she was a psychotherapist for 20 years. So you're very aware of all the emotional issues that are also attached to a home. Isn't that correct?
That is correct.
All right, so Lori's going to start by telling us your first tip. What is it?
My first tip is that if you're planning on getting divorced, everybody getting divorced has to do something with their residence. You're taking two people that are in one home, and no matter what, you're putting them in two different residences. And as you're making the decision and evaluating whether you want to stay in the home or leave the home, there are three things that you need to consider and you need to balance. You need to look at the emotional issues, the psychological issues, and the financial issues. And most people focus on one or the other. They make an emotional decision that they're going to stay in the home or leave the home, or they make a psychological decision because they feel that it's better for the kids one way or the other, or they make a strictly financial decision and they don't balance all three. And if you don't balance all three, then you're really not taking into consideration all of your needs and all of the needs of your family, and that's really important.
It is really important because they are all different needs. I know that when I was going through my divorce, and we talked about this last time, you know, I was emotionally attached because my son grew up in that house. I was, you know, psychologically thinking it's better for him to have the stability and for me to stay put until things calm down and I knew where I was going to stand. And then the financial decisions. I think at the time when I got divorced, the market was at its lowest point. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to hold on so that the market would improve. And it actually did by the time, 3 years later, that I sold the house.
Absolutely.
So these are all important decisions, and you're able to walk through these three issues with each potential client and weigh the options, correct?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And help them make the best decision for them at the time.
Right. And that decision could change over time.
Absolutely.
You know, sometimes it's better to stay in the house for a little while and then move out. Sometimes you just want a fresh start and you just need to get away from anything that reminds you of your past. So there's different reasons. Sometimes you want to, one of the reasons why sometimes couples get divorced is because they can't afford the house even together. And, you know, they're having a financial issue and they come in for a divorce. So they have to sell the house.
Right. And in fact, the first question I usually ask is, do you like the house? Do you want to stay in the house? Do you have a positive feeling about the house? And that really is where it starts. But then you have to decide if you want the house or you don't want the house. Can you afford to keep it? Can you afford to sell it? And what are your real options?
I think that's tip number two, isn't it?
Well, yes, absolutely.
Okay, so tip two.
Tip number two is, if you've decided to keep your house or buy a new house, you need to take a look at, do you have reserves for repairs and emergencies? Do you have money put aside if your house has a 20-year-old roof, or you have an old air conditioner, or you're buying a home? Do you really take a look at those things? Does your realtor take a look at, I don't have reserves for repairs, so I can't look at a house that has a 20-year-old roof or an old air conditioner that's going to need to be replaced? I learned the hard way. When I got divorced, I didn't really think about those things. And a month after I got divorced, I found out that I needed a new roof. Huh. And it was $20,000 that I didn't anticipate. So I come from experience with this. And I know how important it is to make sure that you look at reserves for repairs and emergencies and that sort of thing. And that brings in the third tip, which is, if you're going to be going through a divorce, then you need to have a whole team of experts there that can help you evaluate what you can afford.
Right.
And what your best plan is. You need to have a really good financial planner who understands divorce. You need to have a CPA who understands the ramifications of divorce. You need to have a good divorce attorney.
That's
you need
right.
to have a therapist. You need to have people that are there who understand the process, who can help you and put a team together so that you feel supported through the process and you take into account everything that you need to take into account to make yourself emotionally, psychologically, and financially secure in your decisions.
Right. You know, a lot of times the emotions, I want the house, I want the house, I want the house is all that, you know, it's like, okay, great, you want the house, I get it. So now, how are you going to afford the house? Mm-hmm. How are you going to pay for the house? Is it within your budget? You know, and I don't do budgets, you don't do budgets, that's where a financial
Absolutely.
Planner or a CPA would come in. And sometimes, because it's such an emotional issue, you're not thinking rationally, and that's where the psychologist could come in to help calm you down and help you see through the emotion, the anger, the fear, whatever the emotions are that are keeping you stuck in one position. A lot of times, there might be cash assets that you could get in a divorce as opposed to the house, and those cash assets might do you better justice than the house, depending on the market. Sometimes we're going up, sometimes we're going down. Sometimes something is being built near you that's going to lower the value of your property. Sometimes there's something being built near you that's going to raise the value of your property.
Absolutely.
And that's your job. You know each community. You might say, wow, they're building a brand new school down the block and that's going to raise the value mm-hmm. and you should keep this house because in a year from now, it's going to be worth $50,000 more. I don't know that as a lawyer. And most lay people wouldn't know that, but that's
right.
where you would come in.
Exactly. I think the important thing is there's a lot to consider, and you have to make sure that you have a team of people there to help you make the right decision and make sure that you're considering all of the factors that are involved. It's not just a simple transaction, and it's not just about brick and mortar. Home is where the heart is. It's where we begin and end each day, and there's a really strong emotional connection to our home, and it's a way of being ourselves, and it's a way that we evaluate who we are in a lot of ways. So it's really important.
And we spend a lot of time there.
Important, absolutely.
You know, we spend a lot of time in our home, so you have to really be happy and comfortable. And financially, you need to be happy and comfortable. If you're living in a place where every night you're worried about how you're going to pay your bills, that is not a happy place. It's much better to downsize into something smaller and know that you can afford to live where you are. I know since I've moved, I'm now renting in my son's school district, and if something breaks, instead of worrying, how am I going to fix the air conditioner? How am I going to fix the outdoor screen? What am I going to do about this? I had a water pipe break, and I had to call a plumber. You remember I called you and asked
yes.
you for the plumber.
Absolutely.
And Bougeron was out in a minute. He did a good job. But all costs money. Now all I do is call the landlord. And there's some freedom for that. There's, I could take a deep breath mm-hmm. and not have to worry so much about how am I going to pay for things.
Right.
And there's some freedom in that. Let's talk a little bit, we have a few more minutes, about how we evaluate what a home is worth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of times someone will say, well, my neighbor sold for $250,000, but you're telling me my house is only worth $230,000.
Right.
So why don't we tell the audience a little bit about what goes into evaluation?
Sure. Well, there's really two different ways to evaluate a home. One is to do an official appraisal, and that's done by a licensed appraiser, and that's going to be based on the sales price of homes that have sold in the area in the recent past. And that's really good if what you're planning on doing is refinancing, because that tells you what your house would appraise at by a bank, basically.
But it's also good to have that when you're buying out.
Yes.
You know, if one person wants to keep the house, it's good to have an appraisal as well.
That's where it comes complicated, because there's the appraised value, which is based on what's sold, and then there's the market value, which also takes into account what's currently on the market. So the appraised value may not be what a house would sell for. A house may sell for significantly less or significantly more than the appraised value. A realtor has more leeway than an appraiser. A realtor can base their current market analysis on what is currently on the market and what's sold, so they can give you a more realistic picture of what the house would sell for and how long it might take to sell, because that's based on what else is on the market right now, what your competition is. And it's a completely separate thing. So a lot of people think the appraised value is what it's going to sell for when they're evaluating for a divorce, but that's not true. You really have to take into account what else is on the market, because that may lower or higher the market.
I know, and the condition of the home that's on the market.
Yes.
You know, I know when I was selling my home, there were homes that were on the market for a little bit less than what I was asking. And I said, go over there and look. They have no pool. They have no screened-in patio. They don't have a generator. They don't have shutters. And that's why that house is worth less. If you want to buy that house, go right ahead.
Right.
So when you know, you have to... apples to apples.
Correct.
You have to really understand, maybe your neighbor has marble floors and you only have tile, that's
right.
going to bring down the value of your house.
Right.
Well,
or make it easier or harder to sell.
Yes.
So again, that brings into the marketability of the house, not just the appraised value.
Right, right. And that's important. And curb appeal is very important to some people. Well, we've gone over a lot of information today. I want to thank you so much, Lori, for coming down and joining us.
Thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure to be here with you, Tammy.
Thank you. You can call Lori and find her information on our website at divorceconnectionnetwork.com. The consultation is free, and she is always a great resource of information. Thanks for watching. We look forward to seeing you next time.